थैंक यू. हरे कृष्ण गुरु जी. माय क्वेश्चन फॉर द कर्मा एंड पास्ट कर्मा दैट वी लर्न, लाइक देयर आर मेनी फैक्टर्स डिपेंड्स ऑन इन आवर मैटेरियल लाइफ विद द कर्मा एंड पास्ट कर्मा, एंड इवन इफ समवन सफर्ड और हाउ लॉन्ग विल लाइव इन दिस मैटेरियल वर्ल्ड इट्स सम thing depends on two things. And in that way, if we see the Mahabharata, all the sons of Pandavas, sons of Draupadi, all of them killed in Adharma. They didn't do anything. Son of Subhadra, that he's the nephew of Sri Krishna. Even though Sri Krishna is with them, Sri Krishna has the blessing. They had all the blessings from Sri Krishna. So how, like, they didn't actually do any adharma. So how it's like happened, all of them got killed, all the mothers, their pain, why they lots of pain of their pain for them, why lots of pain to Draupadi. So that's what's like, if we talk about karma and past karma, how it depends with these things, that's trying to understand. Thank you, Guruji.
Yes, Prabhu. So, everyone, we understand your question that they are suffering, even including Arjuna himself. Arjuna himself was put in such a very difficult situation of killing his own like grandfather and his teacher who taught him how to shoot arrows. So, Arjuna has to shoot arrows at him. That's not a great situation at all. So, the problem here is that, Prabhu, in this material world, there is the nature of this material world. Because here, divine and demoniac people are there. So this material world, both divine and demoniac people are there. So the divine people are actually, they will get liberation and go to Krishna. So, Devi Sampati Vimokshaya Nibandaya Asuri Mataga. But the problem is that we are in this material world. That is the problem. So the nature of the material world, like there are Newton's laws of natural, gravitation is there, universal gravity is there, and the Newton's laws of motion. The apple, when it falls from the ground, it will fall to the ground only. Falls from the tree, it falls to the ground. So that is the law. So like that, here in this material world, so we are like all kinds of people are there, everything is there. So this material world itself is full of suffering. So that's why we need to realize and understand that this is a place for suffering. We should not come to this place. So there is no point in asking question that why we are suffering, why this person suffering, why that person suffering. So that is not going to solve our problems. The problems will be solved when we don't come to here. That is the main point. We should not be in a wrong place. When we are in a place where it is dangerous place, normally any dangerous place, we won't go. We know that it's a danger. So even sometimes they will put signboards saying, this is a dangerous zone, don't come here, something like that they put, correct? So something like that, this material world, this earth itself is a dangerous place where we live, where we are living. This place itself is a dangerous place. So we should not be coming here at all. So once we come here, then there is no point in asking question there, why I'm suffering, why I'm struggling, all those things. But there is a way out for us to get out. So Krishna has given us this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita is given to us. So everyone made use of that knowledge. That's what is very important. So even Arjuna, he was suffering, but when he got this knowledge from Krishna, he made use of this knowledge. So then he was able to even kill his Drona, his teacher or his grandfather. He didn't even think further about that. Even his son Abhimanyu also got killed, as you said, all such things. But his motivation is to please Krishna. That is the main thing. He was fully focusing. His mind is only remembering Krishna only. Because Krishna gave him the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So that way we need to understand that Everyone is in this world is going to suffer only because this is a place for suffering. This is a dukkhalaya. There is no doubt. So, but we have got a way out. That is the main thing. This is a human life. This is a human body. And if we effectively make use of this body, make use of this life, make use of our brain and mind and everything to remember Krishna, to connect with Krishna, then we will not come back here and suffer again. So that is the main thing. So we will not come back to this miserable place. That's what is very important. So that way, you need to understand that fact and study and understand this Bhagavad Gita fully. Then we will be able to escape from this place. So we are in a place where it is full of suffering. We need to escape from this place. For that, Bhagavad Gita is the only way. So definitely Krishna is promising that if you get this knowledge, you will come to me. There is no doubt about it. So we surrender unto Krishna. Krishna is saying that you surrender unto me. I will take care of you. You do not fear. Do not worry. So all such things Krishna is saying that once we do that, then we leave everything to Krishna. Then we don't see anything as suffering in this world. So we will not even see death or suffering, anything as something suffering. Because our mind is filled with Krishna. We are always remembering Krishna. That's what is very important. So that's why this Bhagavad Gita knowledge will elevate ourselves to that kind of situation to make use of this life. So otherwise, everyone is going to suffer in this world only. You understand that?
Yes, sir, Prabhu. Guruji, thank you. So in this case, can we say like, or if someone lives shorter, they'll suffer less in their life?
Not really. It is not at all like that. See, someone lives shorter and if they go to Krishna, then you are right. If they live shorter life, after death, if the soul goes to Krishna, so then what you said is correct. In this life, you may be shorter. But the problem is that, are we going to Krishna? Are we ready to go to Krishna? That is the very important point. So that way, the opposite is true, we can say that. If someone lives longer, someone lives 100 years. That's what Srimad Bhagavatam exactly, Sukadeva Goswami says the same thing to Parikshit Maharaja, who was given a death sentence. He will die in 7 days by the biting of his snake. So that way, at that time, Sukadeva Maharaj, he told Parikshit Maharaj, that Sukadeva Goswami told him that, what is the point of living in this world even 100 years if we don't know about ourselves, if we don't serve Krishna, if we don't even have this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita? So this life is useless. There is no use. So that way, we need to understand that making use of all the given opportunity, given time in Krishna consciousness, that's what is very important. So that way, if someone lived shorter life and they go to Krishna, then it is good. So we should not be coming back again. That's the main thing. If we come back again, then we have to die again. If we take birth again, we need to die again. That's a very important thing. So we should not take birth again. But Krishna is saying that it's going to take several births for us to go to Krishna. Neka janma samsiddhaga tato yanti parambam. So we need to take many births. So that way, you understand that, Prabhu?
Yes, Guruji. So, who decides all these things? Like, who lives how long? Does it, there is no, is it Krishna permits or is it the law of the
material? All our karma, our past karma, everyone's karma. So, all these calculations are beyond our imagination. We can't even think about that. So it's this material world is very uncertain for everyone. So that's why Krishna is saying that you don't worry about anything. You just surrender unto me fully. I will take care of you. You don't think about all those things. So you abandon everything. Just surrender unto me. Maam ekam saranam vraja. Aham tvam sarva papebhyo moksha ishyami maa suchakam. So that's what Krishna is repeatedly saying, that you always think of me, become my devotee, worship me. So I will take care of you. Yoga kshema maham yagam. I will bring you what you need. All those things Krishna is repeatedly saying. So if we don't do this, if we don't follow Bhagavad Gita, so then how soon we will die or how long we are going to live and suffer and whatever, all those things. It's all these calculations are based upon our past karmas and a lot of things. Prabhu, they're things we can't even answer. It's beyond our comprehension. So that way we need to leave such things to Krishna only. So whatever the time we have got when we are living here, so it's a great time. We need to make use of it. we cannot miss it, we cannot lose it. So we have to use it in Krishna's service. So that's what is very important. You get to understand that, bro?
Yes, Guruji. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Guruji. Hare Krishna.